people ultimately have the right not to have a genetic test for yourself. You have the right not to have risk reduction surgery. I mean, we live in a free country. You can ride a motorcycle without a helmet here in Arizona. I'm not saying we should force or coerce people, but what I am saying is, for example, a mother who has breast cancer and is the only living relative with cancer and the daughter wants to know for her children and the mother won't test, I say that's a morally wrong decision. I'll say that to anyone. You can quote me on that. You know, the mother doesn't have to know, but help your daughter. If you have a child in the street and there's a truck barreling down the road, don't you have an obligation to get that child out of the street? So I feel like whether it's your daughter, whether you like her or not, if it's your, you know, it just dismays me when we do genetic counseling, and this happens more than you think, where because of these fears, this question I was asked earlier and the reluctance, that some people just won't test. And I think we can't force people to test, but we can talk about ethics and morality. I'm not saying it's a legal obligation to test, but I think you have a moral obligation to test. And if you don't want to be burdened with information, then there's ways to keep that information from you, but that information is critical. So that case I mentioned, if a mother and a family is at risk for this BRCA mutation, and you test the daughter, say, because the mother doesn't want to test, and the daughter's negative, you don't know anything. That's called non-informative negative testing. You still don't know. Now, of course, if the daughter's positive, then it's a moot point. But my point is, if you can't get the index patient to test, that sometimes leads to a problem where the test is negative, but you don't know if it's a true negative. And then the poor woman either has to have risk reduction surgery for unnecessary risk reduction surgery. So that's why I'd like to bring up that this is a moral issue in many ways, not just a legal and a technical and medical issue.
Yeah, and as a matter of fact, I've seen stories recently, Mike, where a patient was informed, found out she was gene positive, however was estranged from her family. Mm. Whoa, big issue. You know, and yeah. Again, nobody can force her to tell the other family members that she's gene positive. But I absolutely support your passion and enthusiasm for everything you've said here. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.